Alright everyone, so after getting it fixed and we have Spark back, I'm gonna go pick up my boy Cortland, of course, my boy with the black and yellow 400EX, and we're gonna go back to Red Oak and hope that we actually get more than 25 minutes of ride time this time. So let's see if she's in fact fixed. If not, this is possibly gonna be another short ride. So the only way to know is to go. I got my 400, Cortland's 400 loaded up. Now let's head on down to Red Oak. We are out here, we are unloaded, and we are about to get riding. About to start these bad boys up, let them warm up for a little bit, and then we're gonna hit the trails. Nice and dry, hot, sunny. I guess we're gonna see how dry it is in the trails, but let's get to it, get y'all on the helmet, and hopefully let's have a good day. Let's have some good, safe riding.
Thank you. Oh, you
got the purple dice on there.
Yeah.
Oh. Don't do this shit again. He was just having a good time. Just got started having a good time. Why do you want to do this? Bruh.
That's a long way, man.
Is it? Oh, yeah. Yeah. This is what we were talking about.
We finally found it.
And I left my damn jump box. I had the jump. Did I put it in the bag?
Yeah.
I did put it in my bag.
Yep.
Did I hold on? Did I take it out?
Is your gas on?
Yeah, the gas is on.
Okay.
Did I put the jump box? I think I put it in the truck. I put it in my bag.
Damn.
Then I took it out my bag because it was heavy.
So I have to ride back and go get it. Yeah, let me do that.
Yeah, I don't think the battery just turned over fast enough to get the motherfucker to start.
It's in the trunk?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, let me turn the damn battery on. Damn, you son of a bitch.
No, it's probably just the battery.
That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping once it starts over faster, then it'll start. My bad. He's gonna go and get my jump starter. I put it in my bag, then I took it out of my bag because it was heavy. So he's gonna go get it out the back of the truck. We hit it with the jump starter and maybe she'll start. Maybe be like last time where we get 24 minutes and 30 seconds of footage and then we end up packing it up and going home.
Oh my God, that feels good riding on the road. Damn air. Well, at least she wasn't in the direct sun.
motherfucker.
Hey, hey, look. Damn, where the damn fuel go now?
Ain't no telling. You lucky motherfucker would have found that.
Hey, listen. That was about to be a needle in a haystack. I must have had it screwed down all the way.
It was even not. You lucky they put it right there, because a little bit more, it would have come out the bottom.
So I smell something burning.
Thank you.
had to put it on reserve. I started sputtering.
Oh shoot.
So I don't know how much gas is in it when it's in reserve. So
damn. Oh, you didn't have much gas in yours?
I mean we filled it up when we rode last time and we didn't ride for that long last time.
Yeah.
So, I mean it should
half the tank.
Yeah, so it should have been enough in there. I don't know what the fuck happened to the rest of the damn gas. Damn, is my fucking jump box dead? Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. You gotta be fucking kidding me. How's my fucking jump box dead? Bro.
Alright, so after the battery died at whatever point, we came back here. Thought I was out of gas. Paid somebody $5 by the gallon of gas. And we're gonna go hit the drag strip for the next about 30 minutes or so. And just get some good races in and see what we can do.
Y'all go head up so we can see. Man, this fucking
damn.
Oh, this goddamn cramp is not fucking going away. Woo, shit. Yeah, I told my.
Yeah, if I miss shift, he got me.
Oh yeah, for sure. For sure.
If I miss shift, that means he got me.
Yeah, gonna line up with him. Thank you. let me push it up, because I got to put this bitch in neutral. The bottom, it kind of bottomed out.
So low, I'm trying to, like, you know, bridge it.
Yeah,
oh, yeah, me too. Yeah,
that's what I was worried about on that first rut that was real deep.
Yeah.
Did it bottom out on that one, or did it just slid right on top? Okay. Because that ridge was huge. I was like, oh, goodness.
Right, yeah. Because I was afraid I was going
to. I thought I was going to slide across it.
I'm going to break an A-arm or something, so that's why I try to stay in the middle or dodge it.
Try to bridge that mud right across that mud, got beaten. So I started going that way. I said, oh, shit.
Yeah, just test it. I'll start.
Hey, we got a hill right here, y'all.
Thank you.
right, y'all, we are back home. It is 11:34 p.m. on a Sunday, and I gotta be up to go to work tomorrow, which is Monday. So everything is all good. The battery on this is like just 100% dead. Like, it won't do nothing. You can see the little light fading out when I try to start it, the neutral light. So battery dead. Gonna order one. It says I'm ordering one. I'll do an install video, which y'all probably don't need, but I'm gonna do it anyway. And then we have a little oil leak, which I think is coming from the stator wiring harness. They probably didn't put RTV around the stator wire harness onto the side cover. So I guess I will try to get that cleaned up real good, and then just take some gasket maker and try to get it up under there, and maybe that'll stop that from... Osmo Action just died. But like I was saying, get some RTV, try to put it around there once I get it cleaned up to stop that from dripping. And other than that, the bike was solid today. So just a battery, little bit of RTV, clean it up, and we should be good for the next one. There's a small spot on the valve cover right there, a little wet, so maybe I will try to tighten those bolts down just a little bit more, but I think I can live with that. So like I said, it's almost midnight. Tomorrow's Monday. I think it's supposed to rain tomorrow and Tuesday, so maybe Wednesday when I cut the grass, which is very high, I will also get Barry White cleaned up, and then he'll sit for another month until I ride it again. So like all things, remember, think, build, enjoy. Peace.